Hello friends, welcome to Step in Web Learning Process. Step in Web is a knowledge sharing portal. It will teach web design basics to the beginners. Welcome to Code Building Tool Video Tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to look after the Notepad++ Part 1. In the Notepad++ Part 1, we are going to see installation and its features and layout components of the Notepad++. Layout component means whenever we are launching that applications, by default it will show some toolbars, menu bar, status bar like that. That component we will explain in that video. What is the purpose? What are the informations available in the each component? And the third part is altering that layout components. Altering layout components means hiding the menu bar, hiding the status bar. So like that, we can change the layout components according to our taste, according to our requirement. Notepad++ having a lot of features compared to Microsoft Notepad editor. Some of the features are, first, it is a open source free software. It has a tapped multiple files editing system. So files are stacked in the tapped manner. So anytime we can select the any file and we can do our editing. And it support around 80 program languages. And if the program languages is not available, then we can use UDL. UDL means user defined language, to customize the our new language. It support syntax highlighting and syntax folding with limited code auto completions. That is a main feature of this Notepad++ compared to Notepad. It will give some tips or suggestion while coding for that language. Also, if you select some starting tag, it will also show the end tag. Same way, if you start typing the keyword of any language, automatically it will suggest the keyword, then you will click the suggested word, it will automatically fill our code, by which it will save our time. Also, it will avoid the error in the coding. In general, remember of all language keywords and functions is very difficult. So just type the prefix of the keyword, automatically Notepad++ will suggest that word and we can select the our required keywords from that selection list. So like that, Notepad++ will support and help to coding the program at a faster way. Also, this Notepad pad having bookmarking and it has a multi-column and multi-line editing facilities, and we can compare the file, and also it has a lot of themes. The themes also we can set it according to our requirement. Also, it have a many plugin to enhance the usage and improve the our web page application views. Now we will see it, how to download the Notepad++ from the website, then how to install it in our system. Open any one of the browser, then you type the Notepad++ download. Automatically it will open the Notepad++ organization website. From that website we can download it, the current version of the Notepad. At present, the current version is 7.86. So I am clicking the current version 7.86. Notepad will go to the its home page for download. In the left side, we can see some 8 options are available. Click the download option. It will shows the all download releases. Already I told Notepad 7.86 is the current version. So I am clicking Notepad 7.86, the first line. Notepad++ has the downloading facility for two types of operating system, One is a 32-bit operating system. So first you have to look in that which operating system your computer has. Then accordingly you have to download the operating system, whether it is a 32-bit or 64-bit. Also, it is having three options to download the system. One is a installer. It is a pure executable file. Straight away you can download it, and by the clicking it will install the entire Notepad++ in your system. In general, most of the users will utilize this installer system only. And another is a zip package and a 7z package. With that also, we have to create some folder in our system. Then you have to download this zipped file to that folder. Then you have to unzip that file. Automatically, it will start install the our Notepad++. So I have downloading installer. The executable file is downloaded in our downloads. Just clicking that file, it will start installing the Notepad++ in our computer. So you can select what is your preferable language. So by default, it will be select English. So I am also selecting English language. Then it will guide you to install the Notepad++ in your system. I am clicking next. Then I clicking agree license agreement. Then it will suggesting some five folders where it has to be installed. By default, it is selecting C program files and Notepad++. I'm just clicking next. Then it gives some components. So whatever the components you want, you can select it like that. I recommended you go to leave it as it is and go for the next. Then it will ask whether we have to create some shortcut on desktop. I am clicking the checkbox. Then I will clicking the install button. So Notepad++ is started installation and it completed the installation. Now you can notice Notepad++ shortcut icon is created in your desktop. By clicking this shortcut icon, it will open the Notepad++ application. Notepad++, that application window can be divided into some 8 parts. In this one part is a window control. In normally in any window applications, this part will be available. It will use to minimize the application window or maximize the application window, or we can close it that application window. For that purpose, this window control commands are used. And another one is the menu bar. Menu bar having a lot of menu commands, and by clicking each menu, it having sub menus, and in sub menu also there will be another sub menus like that. Notepad++ having a lot of commands to ease out our editing facilities. And another part is a toolbar. This toolbar is a minimized icons are showing to execute a commands. Frequently using commands like save, save as, copy, cut, paste, like that, that command will be shown as a small icons in that toolbar. By clicking that command, we can easily execute that command. After toolbar, another control panel is a tapped file system. In Notepad++, it will maintain all the open file in horizontally in a tapped manner. So I can easily select any one of the file and I can do it edit or copy some content. And again, I'll go to the select another file. I can paste it that content. So like that, this tapped file, it is helping to navigate from file to file very easily. And Notepad++ having some facility, we can change the settings. By that, we can arrange this file system in vertical also. So that is as per our convenient, we can keep it top as a tapped manner, or vertically also we can organize it. The status bar is showing the information about the currently activated files, its language, what is the length of the file, how many lines it is having, and what is the position of your cursor, and what is the writing code it is using, and what is the encoding it is using. Like that, lot of informations it will be give. We will see in the later sections. And another part is the lion grid. It will be located left side of the your editing area. It will give the serial number of the your code lines. It will be helpful during debugging your code, and easily we can locate the error lines in by this line grid. Also, Notepad having lot of controls in the pop-up panel system, so we can evocate the panels anytime, and we can use it that command for editing or for changing the settings. And the main area is the working area. Working area is the window is provided below the all toolbars and above the status bar. Here only we are going to write our code and edit our codes. This can be scrolled horizontally or vertically to accommodate any length of code in the system. We see in Notepad++ window having some 8 parts. By Notepad++ settings, we can hide or show that or this menu bar also by change the settings. So now we will look in that how we can hide our menu bar or toolbar or status bar, which will create more space for our editing area. And also sometime accidentally, if menu bar is not visible, then how about to view to again will show that menu bar. For that, the setting is help to understand the controls. So now we will go for the settings and preference, then general. You should to select general. Here you can see this settings, preference and general. In the preference general settings, it having a 6 options are available to change the settings. One is a localization. Localization means it is the language which should be selected. Language means it is our spoken language. Here, while installation of the Notepad++, we selected as a English, so it is showing only English. Suppose now you want to add some other language, then that supported language XML file has to be loaded in the localization folder, in the application folder, then that language also shown in these options. Now it is only available English, so I selected English. Another setting is the toolbar settings. The toolbar setting having one checkbox with the label of hide. Suppose I am checking that hide checkbox, you may see this toolbar is invisible. Again, I will open it the checkbox, you can see the toolbar checklist. And the toolbar having on 3 radio button options, it will show small icons, means you have to select small icons, then big icons, then standard icons. Like that, you can select the icon size by the setting with the radio buttons. So always you have to keep it the toolbar in the unchecked condition, so it will help more. And another setting will be menu bar. The menu bar, if you just check it out, then entire menu bar will be hidden, and if you check out, then that entire menu bar will be again visible. For a shortcut by F10 key, this will be toggled. The menu bar will be hide or show by the pressing of F10 key. Same way, we can hide and show the status bar. Here one checkbox is there, show status bar. If uncheck it, the status bar will be hided. If again check, the status bar will be shown. Another option, tab bar, hide and show. For demo purpose, I have opened a lot of files in my tab bar system. So because the files are unable to accommodate the entire width, so Notepad++ showing some arrow mark for navigate the file. Suppose I am clicking left arrow, then I can navigate to my first file here. Same way, I can put a right arrow, then I can navigate to the last file like that. So Notepad++ will provide a navigation buttons if it is unable to accommodate our total file list. Suppose I am clicking hide in the preference settings, then entire file list will be hided. And the tab bar having some 8 options under the tab bar, but once it is hided, then all the options also will be disabled. So then again I will click the hide checkbox, then it will shows the all file list in the tapped manner, and it having some lot of options. Suppose I click multi-line checkbox, then you can shows the all the files in the multi-lines. So you can see it is formed 3 rows and all the files are shown in the 3 rows. Suppose I click vertical, then all the files are shown in the vertical side like that. So in the vertical side also I can put some arrow mark is there, I can navigate the file to start to end. Same way, if I check the reduce box, it will automatically reduce the font size and height and width of the file name in the tapped bar. So it will can accommodate slightly some more files in the same line. If I check lock, then it will not allow to drag the file from the Window Explorer to the Notepad Plus application window. Then another option is the darken inactive tapes. So you can see this file name, whatever file name it is active, it is slightly white background, and inactive files it is in slightly dark gray. Suppose I uncheck this one, automatically it also changed to slightly white background. It is a light gray background. So always we keep it as a dark and inactive, so easily we can identify the current active file. Same way, Note++ give additional highlight bar over that active file. You can see one orange color lines are placed over the active file name. If I uncheck this draw color bar, then it will be vanished. So again I will check it, then it will shows the orange color bar. And another options in the tab bar is the show close button on each tab. If uncheck, it will all the close button will be vanished. If I check, the close button will be visible in the file menu list. By this close button, we can easily close any file. Just clicking the close button, it will close the file. If that close button checkbox is unchecked, then that now there is no close button is available. But another option Notepad++ provided, by double click the Chrome, it will close the document. If I check this double click to close document, then by double clicking, it will close the documents. By default, if I close all my files in the tab bar, it will again it will open a new one document, and still the application will be in the open condition only. So if I check the exit on close the last tab checkbox, then I am close, after closing it will automatically close the my Notepad++ application also. Another setting is document list panel in the preference general settings. The document list panel is almost equal to the tapped file list shown in the top, but this will show all the files in the left side as a panel box. Suppose I click the show, it will created one panel. In that panel it will shows the all the file list whatever is opened in the window. If I click the disable extension column, it will hide the extensions of the each file. The advantage of this panel is we can position it this panel anywhere in our window. And same way we can switch over our files straight away in the panel. Okay, now you have understand the preference settings for general. So now again I will make it to original default settings. I change the localization will be English, and the toolbar is not hidden and it is put in the standard icons, and the document list panel is unchecked both the option, and the show status bar is checked, and tape bar is not hidden, and darken inactive tapes is checked, draw color bar on active tape is checked, and double click to the close document. Instead of that, I check the show the close button and will inactivate the double click close document. Then I'll uncheck the exit on the close the tape. So like that, I will make it again all the settings to the default settings.
Okay friends, this is the end of the Notepad++ part 1. Please watch next video of Notepad++ part 2. In this video, I am going to explain how to create a new document settings and just start a sample project.
Thank you for watching my video, and please subscribe my channel to grow and share more technical videos. Also, I have written code building tool book, and it is available in the Amazon Kindle. For more details, please read that book. Thank you once again, and bye.